And I'm so proud that London has today chosen hope over fear and unity over division.
When Sadiq Khan was elected Mayor of London 8 months ago, he became the first ever Muslim to lead a capital city in the Western world.
Thanks for your support.
During the campaign, his conservative opponent had made Khan's religion a big issue. Gillian Tett is America's editor of the London-based Financial Times.
There were dark insinuations that Sadiq Khan had somehow become associated with extremism or some extreme Islamic ideas. And Sadiq Khan indicated very strongly that actually he's very much part of the moderate wing of the Islamic population who are trying to fight back against extremists.
American political consultant Rod O'Connor watched the Khan campaign closely.
He's standing up and saying, look, I'm able to represent all people. I'm able to talk to all people. The core beliefs I have are not necessarily based on a religious doctrine. People have tried to exploit questions around religious identity and safety and security tied to religious identity. And this is a very compelling example of a place where you can see that just doesn't work. People look deeper. I think Sadiq gave them an opportunity to look deeper. And they made a choice.
London est ouvert.
Khan says his priorities as mayor are developing affordable housing, investing in transportation infrastructure, preparing youth for the jobs of tomorrow, and ensuring London remains a place that welcomes migrants.
London is open.
At a time when our cities are becoming more diverse, the job of politicians is to make sure we make it easier to integrate, that we bust myths, we build bridges, if you like, rather than walls.
For his part, Khan has reached out to Christian, Jewish, and other religious communities to promote better interfaith relations.
I've never held myself out as a Muslim leader, but it's a fact I'm a leader of Islamic faith, and so that brings with it a responsibility, especially in current times. So during the month of Ramadan, for example, when I was fasting, it was brilliant that, you know, churches and synagogues around London invited me there. The Archbishop of Canterbury invited me to Lambeth Palace, and the Chief Rabbi. We invited 100 children from every borough in London, and the Archbishop and Chief Rabbi and I opened our fast together and took a brilliant selfie as well.
That selfie went viral across Britain and globally. It's symbolic of Khan's common touch, which friends say stems from his upbringing in working-class South London.
My life experiences have made me the person who I am.
Khan's life began in London, the fifth of eight children raised by a bus driver and a seamstress who emigrated from Pakistan in the 1960s. The family lived in a public housing project notorious for its violence.
It was a tough housing project, and you know, you had a choice to either defend yourself or to get beaten up and, you know, be the victim of bullying. So at an early age, all my brothers, I've got six brothers and a sister, we joined the local boxing club because it made you streetwise, you know, how to look after yourself, how to make sure you're safe. Really important, but other skills you learn in boxing as well, how to be magnanimous, how to be a team player, how to keep fit.
What do you think now that you're in the position you're in? Does street fighting still help?
Well, some would say politics is street fighting. How to defend yourself, how to make sure you expose your opponent's weaknesses, how to always be moving, don't stand still. But these are life skills.
Good morning.
Skills that Khan now deploys to connect communities that might otherwise not associate, in a city where, by his count, 300 languages are spoken.
Listen, it's not perfect, but actually we are a great city. You've got in London Christians, Jews, Muslims, Hindus, Sikhs, Buddhists, those not members of an organised faith, rich, poor, old, young, all getting on, interconnected lives, breaking bread together, studying together, working together. We can't have a laissez-faire attitude towards integration. We've got to think about our schools, about our colleges, about places of work. Are we ensuring that everyone has a chance to fulfill their potential, to meet their neighbours and to get on?
Khan has also encouraged religious and other minorities to report to law enforcement any and all hate crimes, which spiked upward after the UK voted last summer to leave the European Union.
The good news is, though, is that the police and myself and others have a zero tolerance towards hate crime. The public had confidence to report it, which is very, very important. I'm a firm believer in stamping out at an early stage name-calling, verbal abuse, before it escalates. And I'm really pleased that, you know, we will carry on being a great, great city that doesn't just tolerate difference, respects it, embraces it, and celebrates it.